about to do a little work on my trailer, and you can see here that I've made some tabs that I've seen on some forums to secure your plywood, your flooring system to your trailer. And I like that because that kept holes out of my frame and hopefully will help reduce rust over time. So I'm going to drill those out, and I got some carriage bolts, some stainless steel carriage bolts that's going to go in those. So I'll get started on those and show you that work. So what we have here is a 5/16 carriage bolt. It's stainless steel, and I'm going to have a nylon nut on the back of this. I got some washers and stuff. It's over there. But anyways, I'm going to drill these out, and I'm going to start off with a small one and then step up to my 5/16. So we'll get started on that. I'm working on my frame a little bit more here, and I noticed when I went down to go pick up my plywood, it was about a 3-hour drive, I noticed it kind of rubbed it a little bit on my frame, which, you know, it wasn't bolted down or anything, but I kind of thought, well, maybe in the long run it might start to rub down that paint eventually, so I was looking for some kind of barrier in between my plywood and my frame. Got online, did some research, looked at some other builds. Someone had used just some caulking, and I didn't want to go that route. And then I ran into someone that used this Protecto Wrap. And what it is, it's BT25XL Protecto Wrap. And this particular one is 4 inches wide, so I've been cutting it down into 2-inch strips to fit my trailer. And it's just a peeled back, you know, and it's sticky here, and that just goes right on. So I'll throw one of those on. I got one more I'm about to do here, just to kind of show you how I'm throwing that on. And I still have to do where I'm going to bolt my trailer down, and then also a little bit of my frame, because I'm going to build a box on the front of my frame. That's pretty much how easy that's been going on. Like I said, I'm going to finish it up. And then after that, I need to spray my bed liner on my floor, and then we'll be ready to start putting this thing on. I started fitting the floor on my trailer, and I put some epoxy and some filler mixed together to start filling in my knot holes I had on this side of the plywood. The other side of the plywood is my good side. That doesn't have any knot holes in it. I'm going to fiberglass that side and then bedliner spray it. This side, I'm going to have to water seal it, and then I'm going to put bedliner on it. And I wanted to fill up those holes, so I didn't have any chance of my bedliner cracking, getting down on those holes and anything like that. Anyway, so that's where I'm at. When these set up and harden, I will sand them down flat. That's pretty self-leveling. I made it a little thin, not real super thick paste. So hopefully, if you can see on some of these, it's pretty self-leveling. But I'll still have to go over it with the sander. Of course, I got to sand all this anyway. So when this sets up, we'll keep on going. Show you real quick what else I did on my trailer. I'm going to have 5/16 stainless steel bolts holding my flooring down, and I took my 5/16 drill bit, and since I'd previously drilled out my anchor points on my trailer, I was just able to come up through the floor to get my hole to match. And then I took a Forstner bit and then I recessed it down like that. So when I go to put these in, I can just knock that down. It'll be flush and smooth on top of my trailer, and I don't have to worry about those protruding up. Anyways, that's that real quick. I did that on all the way around the trailer. And when we get to that, I'll show you fastening that down. I'm back to working on my floor on my trailer here. And I've taken it off the trailer, put it over here so I could work on it. And I sanded it down with 80 grit paper to get a nice uniform levelness out of the board. And then also, I also needed to sand down where I'd put my epoxy filler and my knot holes. And so now we need to water seal this so I can spray bed liner on it. And this is actually going to be, this section is actually going to be the interior side of the trailer, and the other side is the side that we're going to fiberglass. But so to water seal this, we're going to use what is called the mix, and it's spar varnish and mineral spirits. And you start out with 25% of the polyurethane and then 75 mineral spirits, and then you work your way down to just the full polyurethane. And the thought process in that is the mineral spirits helps the spar varnish get into the wood better, thins it down a little bit, and then it evaporates. So the mineral spirits will eventually just evaporate out. So that's what I'm about to do, and I'll get started on that and show you what it looks like when it's all done. Just thought I'd show you real quick throwing this on. I'm just using a regular old chip brush here and just kind of sopping it on. And I will just work my way down to the end down there, and I'll show you when it's all done. So I threw the first coat on here. That's what we got going on. Still drying, and that's the difference. My trailer's not going to go out this far, so that's the difference between the first coat and just the dry plywood. Okay, today I'll be starting fiberglassing the underside of my Teardrop trailer floor system. I've never fiberglassed before. This is my first time. I have practiced on some test boards. Didn't seem too terribly hard. I'm using the RACA. Do some research online. A lot of people either use this or the West system. Just whatever your preference is. I got the pumps that go with it that helps get your mixture correctly for your resin and your blush there, or your hardener and your resin. I ended up going with a 3.25 ounce tight weave. I've seen some other builds use it, seem like it works pretty good. This is mainly just for water seal barrier, so it's not like I'm using it for structural. Like when you start getting into some of the heavier ounce fiberglass cloths or even mats. So I'll get set up, get everything set it started, and I'll show you some footage and what it looks like after we're done here. I've started sanding down my fiberglass here, and as you can see, there's some areas that are definitely high and low that I still need to knock out. I started out with my Orbital sander here with 60 grit paper, and man, that was just that was slow. I got tired of doing that. I switched over to my belt sander. I threw some 80 grit paper on there, and that was just too much. It took it down. You might be able to see the fiberglass cloth in there. So then I switched over to 120. That seemed to work pretty good. If you just kind of didn't put very much pressure on the sander, it seemed to take off just about the right amount that needed to come off without getting actually down into the cloth. So I'm about to do a little bit more sanding and then wipe everything down. Hopefully I can be spraying my bed liner tonight. So yeah, I'll just keep on moving along and show you what I got towards the end here. So I got my first coat of Raptor bed liner spray on, and it took about a bottle and a half to get this. This is about a 9x10 sheet piece of plywood here. So after I sanded it, I put this grip 4 as adhesion promoter on it, and then I sprayed it with my Raptor bed liner. And now I have to wait about an hour before I can spray it again. It says about 60 minutes between coats, so I will get that shot and show you when it's done. I flipped my floor over, and this is going to be the top side of the flooring system. And before I spray this side with bed liner spray, I want to cut my dados out for the dividers in my subfloor. So I went to Lowe's and picked me up some of these 100 inch long guides because of the dado I need to cut. It's going to be about 70 inches. So I've kind of set up a little unconventional way of doing a dado, but hopefully, so you can get in there. That's my line, and that should ride all the way down that one there. So hopefully this works out, and then I'm gonna have to come over here to this other side for my other divider and cut that out, and hopefully I can duplicate that the same way. And so I'll make my cuts and then I'll show you how it goes. Just got done making that cut. Here's what it looks like. So hopefully that works out and I can duplicate it on this side over here. All right, I got my dados done for my flooring here, and I temporarily installed my dividers. That's going to be my storage area underneath my mattress, because my mattress is going to go up here. Then I'll have the areas down here for storage. I've made them a little long right now just because of the way the teardrop has the curve in the front, so I'll figure that out a little bit later. But I just kind of wanted to show you a little bit back here too. So this area here is going to be where the galley's at. And then I'm going to have my bulkhead that fits up against this. And if you remember, I had my bulkhead cut out. So it's actually going to be, so this middle one here, where I can slide my canopy tent, my long items up there. And then I'll still have access to my side storage, if you remember earlier from that door that I cut out of my side walls. So that's where we're heading. And I'll just keep on moving along here. Okay, I got this sprayed now. I had taped off where my dados are going to go. And I also had taped off the edge here, because this is like a mock-up of my wall. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to wet this out and then put epoxy and filler when I go to put it all together. That way it creates a nice, tight, strong bond, and also will seal that up against the weather. Anyway, so that's where I'm at. We're gonna let this dry, and then eventually we'll get it over here onto the trailer. One more quick thing I wanted to mention about these partitions that are gonna go in the middle there of those dados is they're gonna have to go with the curve in the front of the teardrops. What I did is I laid them on here, and then I just got under here and traced it. And so now I'm going to cut this with the jigsaw, put it back on my middle board here, and then router that flush, and that'll give me a good fit. So those partitions will curve with the flow of the front of the teardrop. Alright, so that's what this is going to look like when it's in the trailer. That's going to go along with the front curve of the teardrop when it rides and my dado's there. I got the partitions bed liner sprayed now, and just gonna let those set up. Just put some dados in a 2x4 here so I could set them up like that and put them in there so I could spray both sides. And we'll get started on the actual floor tomorrow. Right now I am working on my floor system. The mattress will go on top of this, and I got one wall done, and that's the dado cut that I made for it. And that piece of plywood, when I get it cut down, will fit in here like so, like that, and that'll be my floor. So I got to cut that. So I've measured this out from back here to up there, and that's 79 1/4 inches. So I'm gonna make that cut right now. Wanted to show you real quick, the base of this trailer is 60 inches wide, and I'm actually gonna have to cut down this to 58 3/4 instead of 60 inches. And that's because I've cut these dados out 3/8 inch deep. So 3/8 3/8 3/4. So with my wall on my trailer here, that takes an inch on each side. So that goes from 60 inches wide to 58 inches wide. But this needs to fit in those dados, so that's why we are going to 58 3/4. So I'm going to cut this down next. I've started on the mattress floor here, and I've put in 3 access holes that I'll be able to get access to the storage underneath from inside the cabin. And what I've done is I just plunge cut these square holes out with a straight edge with a skill saw. Then I came back around and I measured out the width of my router for a 1/2 inch rabbet bit. And then this is one of the cuts that I made. That way I knew how far I could travel here to the edge. I didn't do that on the first one over here, and it got away from me a little bit. You can tell there. Made it a little bit too deep, but essentially what I want to be able to do is just a little bit easier access from either inside the cabin to where I can grab something real quick, or if I want to store something long term in a bin like that, it's just easy to open this up, put it in the back, because I might not have access, might not be deep enough, you know, for some of the stuff that I want to store, the door that from the exterior side. So pretty much this will, you know, lay flat, and all I've done is dadoed out, I'm rabbeted out this, and then I made this cut here so that fits flush, and then so now that should be able to fit in there. That'll sit down, I can put the top back on it. I've started securing the floor to the trailer here, and from previously when we had taken a Forstner bit and made these holes here, what I've done is just gotten these carriage bolts, stainless steel, and I took this like a socket here, and then I just took my hammer, knocked it down in there, and then I got a washer, and I got a little rubber washer as well to go on there to seal, to help maybe with water intrusion on the bottom side, and then just some nylon nuts so those don't back off while going down the road. And I'll get underneath here, and so that's pretty much what it looks like. Rubber washer, that should help seal that a little bit, and then that nylon nut should not back off. So I'm just going to finish out the rest of these throughout the trailer.